tell you about the ant story. Everything that I'm speaking is there in the notes. You have to fill in the gaps so that this notes and the script stays with you and it's yours. Then you can apply this. And then you put the photo there below which you write down one line can change. Make sure it's your photo. I'm going to tell you about the ant story. How many of you have seen ants?
Everybody.
How many of you have not seen ants? How many of you wouldn't raise the hand no matter what I ask? Some people wouldn't raise the hand, they'll be sitting throughout. Dekhte hai speaker kya banta. Dekhte hai, matlab theek hai, okay.
Let him soak.
Let him soak. It's not about me, it's about you. I may be the worst speaker with the worst content. My point is, could you pick up something which can change your life? That's more important. My imagination is useless. See if you can pick up something valuable which can change your life forever. One point. Satya Vachan.
Take action.
I should about that? LIRT 15 minutes. Okay, everybody else. Ant story. I give these examples in the smallest program that I conduct is a 5-day program. So I was thoroughly challenged when they told me I have to do a 1-hour talk. I said, I didn't know what to do for 1 hour. Atul was there for the 3-day program. The smallest program that I do is a 5-day program. So I'm extremely challenged right now because I know I have to give you something which is valuable. You're giving me 1, 1.5, or maybe 2 hours today. I don't know how much the talk will go. Or I don't know when you will go. Somebody meant. Okay. So in the 5-day course that we conduct, that I tell this example, the ant story. Have you seen an ant going and you keep something in front of it? You know what the ant does? It changes the path that it goes. You keep something there, it changes the path that it goes. Keep something on the third side, it finds another way. Keep something on the fourth side, it finds another way. It is not going to stop and think. It's going to keep moving. And you close that thing, it's going to move inside and move and move and find a possibility or die. It is going to work till the last point. Isn't that a good philosophy to work with for the rest of your life? That you will find solutions. You will keep moving. You will keep working, you will keep moving. And no matter what the stops are, no matter how many blocks you get, no matter as many you may be surrounded from all sides, your attitude will not change, your actions will not change, your intentions will not change. You will change. You will continue to work for that big goal which you promised yourself so that tomorrow when you meet your today's self, that when you look back onto life and you will say, I made that promise to myself in 2015 and today is 2030. And yes, I'm proud to live that. I'm proud to have worked that. Would you be proud? Would your family be proud? Would your children be proud? Would they be a proud followers? To carry your body on the final journey. I woke up this morning and I read the death of Dr. Wayne Dyer. He's been my teacher sometimes in the past and I learned a lot from Dr. Dyer. And I remember one thing that he said. He said that when I was in my late youth, I cut the pockets of a suit just to remind me that the final suit that I will wear will have no pockets. That's my tribute to Dr. Dyer, from whom I continue to learn, one of the teachers. He continues to inspire me with the books that he's written. Great man. Would you, or would somebody talk about you like this, when they know? Very important to have touched lives, to to have brought changes in lives, to have sold something which is larger than ourselves, to transform. So this ant will keep moving, no matter what the blocks are, no matter what the blockages are, no matter how much you stop it, it will keep moving. It will keep moving. And you see, the ants are always in a hurry. Have you noticed that? They're always in a hurry. You know why they're in a hurry? Because they know that winter is coming. And before winter comes, I have to gather the stock. Because while in winter, I have to be ready to face the winter. They're always in a hurry, gathering food, going to the house. Gathering food, going to the house. Go, go, go. They're always in a hurry. They're gathering food for the winter. And you know what happens when winter comes? They sit and they talk. They bond. They unite together. They don't complain of the winter. They don't complain of the downfall. They don't complain of the recession. They unite together. They bond. They build better relationships with the family because they've got sufficient food for this winter. And you know what's the best thing they tell themselves by this winter? They tell them, summer is coming. Summer is coming. That's the promise of the future. Summer is coming. And you know when summer comes, they gather more. They build empire. They build a fortune for the winter. The ant knows that after every summer, there's a winter. And for the last 6,500 years of recorded history, winter has always followed summer. And for the last 6,500 years of recorded history, summer has always come after winter. So if your profits are high, be ready, it's going to go down. My question is, when it's going down, how ready are you to face that? How much did you think when your company is growing that you have to be ready for that winter? Because for 6,500 years of recorded history, there was never a one side up. There's an up and there's a down. There's an up and there's a down. The stories of great companies are written when it's down, not when it's up. The stories of great companies were written when things were down, not when it was up. In one of her autobiographies, Sudhamurti wrote that there was one Diwali where I had to sell my last bangle to only to feed my family. And that's the story of Infosys, the first company to be listed on NASDAQ. And go check around history. Go check around the world. Great companies were made, and not in favorable situations, but in trials and tribulations and unfavorable situations. A Michael Jackson was made in that filth and the trouble and the trials, right? Then stop sowing.